Olive was wearing a white shirt, a black suit jacket and a bow tie. She was in a huge kitchen. Chefs in tall white hats running around, one using a large metal spoon to ladle soup out of a huge steaming pot and another icing a big cake with a piping bag.
Cake? This is a really busy place.
She could hear someone smashing plates and she went off to see what was happening. She noticed a rosy-cheeked manager surrounded by broken plates.
Oh, hello,
said Olive.
Ah, bonjour, mademoiselle,
said the manager.
My name's not mademoiselle, it's Olive. Pleased to meet you. Are you okay?
I'm Pierre Petitpois, and it is the opening night of my restaurant, Le Mange Tout.
Well, that's great,
exclaimed Olive.
Oui, but the head waiter has not turned up and the famous food critic Monsieur Le Croc is coming. How am I going to serve everyone their food on my own? C'est impossible.
Oh dear. Well, I could help you, but you'll need to show me what to do,
said Olive.
What a magnifique idea.
So Pierre showed Olive how to serve like a real waitress. She had to hold a tray with one hand, pour grape juice into a glass with another, meanwhile serving the finest sausage and mashed potato with two silver spoons.
Oh, heck, I'm not sure I'm very good at this,
said Olive.
Oh, quel dommage. This will never work. We need to go faster.
Faster?
Thought Olive. Just then, Olive remembered all the equipment from the kitchen.
A silver ladle? A piping bag? I think I may have an idea.
Olive went to fetch the two items from the kitchen.
When it's time to serve the food, you hold up the customer's plates and I'll catapult the sausage and mashed potato onto them. Then I'll squirt the grape juice from the piping bag into the glasses. We should be able to serve them all in no time.
Olive, this idea is fantastic.
Very soon, the restaurant was full of hungry customers. So Olive and Pierre got to work, catapulting, catching, aiming and squirting. The food critic, Monsieur Le Croc, had arrived and was sitting, waiting for his dinner. It was all going so well until Olive began to serve the food a little too fast and Pierre couldn't keep up.
Olive, you must slow down,
warned Pierre.
Or something bad is going to...
But before he could finish, Olive catapulted the mashed potato into the food critic Monsieur Le Croc's face and the sausage into his mouth.
The whole restaurant fell silent.
Monsieur Le Croc, I'm ever so sorry. Are you okay?
Monsieur Le Croc didn't move for a second. Then he took a big bite of his sausage and licked his lips.
Magnifique. I have never seen service like it. I award Le Mange Tout the highest honor, La Golden Fork.
Pierre could believe it.
Oh, mademoiselle, you saved the day.
All in a day's work, Pierre. But my name's Olive.
They both laughed. And as they did, Olive realized it was time to go.
Done, Claude. You put the fire out.
But Claude didn't.
What's the matter, Harry? I don't want to cross the muddy patch.